We have a couple questions, and one of them was about, can you expand a little bit on how trusts can help you not go to the bank when you're buying someone else's property?
Yes. Great question. And, you know, it's something that I was forced to learn way back in 1982. Even before that, when I was buying my first property, I was able to take over the existing financing on the property. And that was magnificent, right? For $45, I could step in. I could take over somebody else's financing. It was fantastic. However, in 1982, they passed a law that said and gave the banks the right to put the due upon sale clause in the mortgage. And so as a result, boom, the $45 to take over somebody else's loan disappeared because they put the due upon sale clause in the mortgage. However, when I read the law, I discovered something amazing and powerful. And it said, except when you place your property in trust for estate planning purposes, the lender is prohibited from calling the loan due. And so I went, hello, I need to learn more about these things called trusts. And that's what forced me to go out there and learn about the most amazing entity on the planet. I was actually forced to do it by a law. And I'm telling you, it's one of the best things that ever happened to me. So the answer is that a seller could place their property in trust. And then rather than you purchasing the real estate, you could actually purchase the beneficial interest of that trust. So when you purchase that beneficial interest, that is not published on public record. So therefore, the lender would not be aware that anyone else was actually the beneficiary of that trust. And what's great, and of course, in documentation and step-by-step processes and formulas, and of course, this is something that we've done now for decades, and I will hasten to say that certainly that law could have been changed since 1982, but it never has been. And here's the reason, I think, because the banks actually benefit from it. Think about it. If you come along and you're interested in a property and it's behind in payments, $5,000, $10,000, $20,000 behind in payments, the people are living in the house, they're not making the payments, and the bank is hurting because they're not receiving those payments. Then you come along as an investor, you're able to take over that existing loan. Now, what's in it for you? Well, you just save thousands of dollars on getting a brand new loan from the bank because you're not having to pay all those points, closing costs, origination fees, all the things that typically go with creating a loan. So you step in. You take over, you pay the seller whatever they want. You're taking over the existing fine or whatever you negotiate, and whatever problem you're solving for them as a result of you buying that property. And now you take over what? The payments on that loan. However, you're also going to reinstate that loan in most cases. So if you reinstate that loan, well, hello, the bank just won, didn't they? They just got a big fat payment. And they're now going to get consistent, regular payments. So the bank wins. Now you win because you didn't have to pay points, closing costs, origination fees, and all that stuff. You didn't have to put up your credit report. You didn't have a delay in acquiring the asset. And the seller benefits too. They got rid of their property. They got rid of their headache. And you can even pay them more in circumstances where you can take over the existing financing. Now think of this, and because maybe they were behind in payments and now you've reinstated the loan, what does that do for their credit? And think about this, every month, month after month, you're making those payments on time. What does that do for the seller's credit? That makes the seller's credit go up. So I call this a win-win-win. Everybody wins in this deal. And so all I ask you to do is when I teach this to you and I do have the documentation and you're going to use that, just know that your commitment is to make those payments, make those payments on time, help that seller out, help them restore their credit, help them build their credit. And at the same time, look what you've done. The bank wins because they're receiving payments now, regular payments. The community wins because that could be a foreclosure. That could be some kind of vacant property that the bank takes on, and who knows how long it would be before they fix it up and rent it out or sell it and put it back into circulation. And you come along and you actually are helping the community with housing. So there's a lot of wins in here. Everybody wins. And I just encourage you to learn more about that. That is a big session that I'm going to do during the Maximum Asset Yield training as well. Great question.